Mendapat Taka as my first supervisor, and good afternoon, Mr. Jan Peterson Son Leonokas, as my second supervisor. Thank you for the time given to me. Now I would like to present my research proposal entitled The Use of Sunday School English Song Videos to Improve Listening Skill for Elementary Sunday School Student through Tunas Vandenbroek English Tutoring in Parjemaat Kota Kupang. In my research proposal, there is introduction in chapter 1, there is background. The paragraph 1, I discuss about the influence of listening. It means that has a big influence for everyone, especially in communication, because for starting a conversation with others, people need to listen carefully. And the next, as a second paragraph, discuss about listening is a skill. So it means that listening is a skill to receive message effectively, and not just listen, but also listen a bit to understand well about the meanings from the speaker. And next is the problems of teaching English in listening class. We also know that problem of teaching English, many teachers, when they teach, use the various method is the way to them to set a comfortable situation, but those teaching techniques they use are not enough. So in the next paragraph, as a researcher to solve these problems, the researcher tries to suggest a new method in listening class. And the last paragraph, the researcher discuss about learning English through songs.
Truth.
Singing, because singing song can motivate to learn English by listening, it helps students to improve their English and afford to create enjoyable situation in class. Okay, the next is the research problem. The research problem is, can Sunday school English song videos improve listening skill of elementary Sunday school student through Tunas Vandenbroek English Tutoring of Jemaat in Jemaat Kota Kupang? It is the research problem statement. And the next is aim of the research. The aim of the research, just one aim, that is to know whether Sunday school English song videos can improve listening skill of elementary Sunday school student through Tunas Vandenbroek English Tutoring in Parjemaat Kota Kupang. There are two benefits that researcher prepare here. The first one is theoretical benefits and practical benefits that you can see in the slide. there are two benefits in theoretical and two benefits in practical. And the next.
Can you stop for a moment, please? Can you go back to the previous slide? Yeah, that one. You many times you use the word through. Why do you have to use through Tunas Vandenbroek English Tutoring in Parjemaat? So what is this Tunas Vandenbroek English Tutoring? Is it a program or it's a name of the place? Why through Tunas Vandenbroek?
Tunas Vandenbroek, it is the name of the research, yeah.
Name of the?
The name of place that it is a program from Cahaya Bangsa Negeri Foundation.
Jadi karena melalui, coba kalau diterjemahkan bagaimana? Jadi coba pelan-pelan.
Melalui.
Sabar, to know whether Sunday school English song videos can improve listening skill of elementary Sunday school students. Jadi yang elementary Sunday school students itu mereka belajar di mana? Itu student di mana punya?
Tunas Vandenbroek, sir.
Kenapa through?
The Tunas Vandenbroek is the name.
Ya, kenapa through? Kenapa bukan in?
Mereka belajar di mana?
Atau off?
Students of what?
A student of Tunas van. Jadi pakai of saja di sini toh. Elementary school
betul.
Of Tunas
of itu.
Van den Broek. Kenapa through terus? Kayaknya saya sudah pertanyakan penggunaan kata through ini ya.
Of Tunas van den Broek English tutoring.
Iya, karena itu student yang dimaksud kan Tunas van den Broek.
Of saja. Kenapa dia pakai
ya?
Through ini?
Terus
saya kayaknya pernah rombak itu, mak dia.
Through Tunas van den Broek English tutoring. Oh, sabar ya, sabar.
No, wait.
Jadi itu sebuah program maksudnya.
Yes.
Melalui, oh kamu tadi sebutnya apa ini nah? Ini program berarti ini tutoring.
Jadi English tutoring.
Sabar ya.
Yeah.
Ini kan program dari Van den Broek English tutoring. Terus itu anak-anak par itu par di kota jemaat kota Kupang ya?
Yes, sir.
Oke.
Okay. Jemaat kota Kupang.
Jemaat kota Kupang. Yeah. So they actually the activity is not conducted at the Tunas van den Broek school begitu ya? Eh? No. Only you or they only use the tutoring materials. Van den Broek tutoring materials.
Tunas van den Broek.
Tunas van den Broek English tutoring itu nama program ya, nama aplikasi atau nama program kah?
Nama aplikasi atau program?
Iya pak.
Apa itu? Iya iya. Ya, jadi ada buku ya, yang judulnya
ini bekerja ini bimbel yang bekerja sama dari dari Jakarta Cahaya Bangsa Negeri.
Hmm.
Jadi Cahaya Bagi Negeri.
Cahaya Bagi Negeri.
CPN punya. Jadi kami ini sebagai dia punya cabang saja, Pak.
To know whether
yang namanya Van den Broek English
can improve.
Iya, iya. Namanya Tunas Van den Broek, iya.
Itu programnya. Through Tunas Van den Broek.
Ya, programnya.
Ring. Berarti benar ini penggunaan kata through ini. Melalui program Tunas Van den Broek English Tutoring di par jemaat. Jadi listening skill of elementary Sunday school students.
Yes.
Ada yang jadi di Sunday school itu ada yang ada elementary, ada secondary.
No, just elementary. And all of the students are
elementary.
Sunday school students. Jadi kami rekrut anak-anak cuhanya anak-anak dari anak-anak sekolah minggu saja yang ikut di bimbingan belajar kami, Pak.
Kenapa ada
anak sekolah minggu yang SD saja?
Iya, iya, sekolah
dasar. Kenapa ada elementary
kenapa ala, ya, kenapa ada elementary? Berarti ada ini. Cara kamu tulis student. Elementary juga salah. Elementary, mentari.
Oh, yes.
Iya.
Mentar.
Sunday school student element. Saja sebenarnya.
Ya, nah kenapa harus ada elementary?
Kenapa harus ada elementary? Karena saya berpikir bahwa karena yang ada di semua anak-anak yang ada di tempat bimbingan belajar ini hanya anak SD saja. Dari kelas 1 sampai kelas 6.
Hmm.
Itulah kenapa saya pakai elementary.
Oh. Oke, jadi kamu harus bisa jelaskan nanti bahwa yang kamu maksud elementary itu bukan Sunday school yang elementary, tetapi student itu yang elementary sebenarnya. Tapi jadi, dengan penggunaan di situ, penggunaan elementary di situ kelihatan seperti di gereja itu ada elementary,
ada sekolah,
ada elementary ada class, ada secondary class, ada advanced class mungkin.
Yeah.
Seperti itu memang pengertian kalau baca itu kalimat itu. Jadi menggunakan itu Tunas van den Broek English tutoring di par itu sana ya. Di par jemaat kota Kupang. Nah, istilah par ini juga nanti harus dijelaskan di satu tempat itu. harus salah satu menjadi salah satu yang term that you need to explain. Par, what you mean by par?
In the point of in the point of scope and limitation, or definition of terms.
Definition of terms. Definition of terms. You need to explain one by one. What you mean by par? Because it is separated. It is a different organization from the Tunas van den Broek English Tutoring. Yeah. When you say tutor English, Tunas van den Broek English Tutoring, you also need to mention the name of the organization, Tunas apa, Cahaya Bagi Bangsa, Bagi Negeri, Cahaya Bagi Negeri itu.
Bagi Negeri.
Ya, itu harus di, karena dia tidak muncul di sini.
Incomplete definition. Hmm. On page 5, Tunas van den Broek, you need to explain also that Tunas van den Broek is an organization.
It's a program that belongs
program,
to
that
belongs to Cahaya Bagi Negeri organization.
Yeah.
Itu harus dijelaskan begitu. Jangan lari-lari.
Dijelaskan.
Karena itu mempengaruhi nanti kualitas atau hasil, mempengaruhi hasil dari temuan waktu penelitian itu.
Ya. Bisa juga kalau elementary-nya di omitted. Jadi nanti di scope and limitation baru kau contohkan,
baru jelaskan
yang
tentang
Sunday school students.
Ya, betul.
Ya, yang Sunday school itu adalah mereka yang hanya elementary. Jadi elementary-nya tidak perlu dipakai di judul.
Elementary school.
Tapi di,
saya setuju.
Ya, elementary
school. Di judul school, berarti di judul
itu dijelaskan. Ya, di judul pertama. Nah, di single skill of Sunday school students.
Ya.
Nanti kau jelaskan di scope and limitation bahwa yang dimaksud dengan Sunday school itu adalah mereka semua yang elementary school di jenjang pendidikan yang begitu. Dari jenjang pendidikan mereka elementary school saja.
Ya.
Ya.
Okay, thank you, sir.
You know.
Okay.
Yeah, whenever you meet the term elementary, then you have to omit it. In the discussion of definition of terms, then you can mention. Apa ini, sabar, konteksnya di situ menyebutkan elementary level, each level subject, each subject level atau each level subject. Yes. Is collaborative. Is itu kalau diikuti dengan kata kerja itu hanya bisa pasif, hanya bisa ed, collaborated.
Pasif sebenarnya.
Iya. Tidak ada istilah is collaborated.
Jadi collaborated with. Ini mesti ini pasif ini. Simple present passive. Simple present passive.
Its subject
is collaborated with CBN.
Its subject level.
Berarti subject level dari skala kolaboratif.
Kamu simpan dulu, save dulu. Control S. Control S saja.
Ya.
To improve.
Kalau yang bagian bawah, kalau ini bagian definition of terms, ini cuma saya taruh singkat saja, Pak. Kalau di proposal, jelaskan.
Taruh catatan di situ. Kalau ada proposalnya, kalau ada proposalnya di situ, taruh catatan tentang itu tadi. Catatan tulisan tangan di proposal.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Waktu kamu sebutkan PAR itu PAR itu kan bukan satu kata lumrah itu. Itu kan singkatan. Jadi
itu abbreviation.
Itu abbreviation itu. Jadi waktu di proposal itu kamu harus jelaskan PAR stands for apa?
Ya.
Apa itu program kah atau pendidikan anak remaja kah atau apa itu? Pelayan orangnya lagi. Ini kan program atau section itu pelayanan anak dan remaja.
Ya.
Jadi itu harus dijelaskan juga. Jadi jangan hanya bilang PAR jemaat ini. PAR is one of Kota Kupang Gemi Church Service. Itu yang apa? Yang melayani bidang apa? Anak dan remaja itu kan harus disebutkan kalau itu tidak
disebutkan.
Tidak hanya bilang salah satu
dari pelayanan itu. Definition of terms itu PAR itu.
Jadi itu seksi khusus yang menangani seksi di gereja in Gemi Church deals with service for
belum ada itu
children and adolescents.
Ya.
Ya, begitu toh.
Ya. Adolescents.
Ya. Deals with
service kepanjangannya.
Ya. Itu baru bisa menjelaskan
belum.
Di jemaat Kota Kupang, in the Kota Kupang Church, Gemit Church. Nah, Gemit juga itu kan orang dari Amerika yang baca Gemit itu kan tuan tidak tahu apa itu Gemit.
Ya.
Kalau kamu gunakan kata apapun di situ, itu harus diperjelas. Pertama kali the first time you use a new term, you have to write completely. You have to spell all the complete words for a term.
Yeah.
Then you put Gemit, for example, in brackets. Then the second time you use it, you may only use the word Gemit. But the first time, you have to mention the full, complete words.
Yeah.
Anak dan remaja.
Anak dan remaja.
Okay, dalam kurung, tutup kurung. Itu cara menuliskan kurung. Itu jangan spasi. Mepet semuanya, tidak ada spasi itu. Teknik penulisan tidak ada spasi. Sana juga. Siapa yang ajar spasi di kurung dipakai spasi. Terus jangan one of itu is a section in the church is a section in the Gemit Church that deals with the service for children and adolescents. A section in the Kota Kupang Gemit Church in the
Gemit.
Kota Kupang.
A section in Kota Kupang Gemit Church. Yeah.
That that deals with children and the service. That deals with the service. The service for children.
For, not of.
For children.
Yeah.
And adolescents. Nanti cari tahu adolescents, adult. adolescents. Apakah senche?
Boleh.
Apakah tulisnya begitu ya, adolescents begitu atau chances? Adolescent.
Yes, adolescent.
Ya begitu.
Chances. Adolescents.
Adolescent.
Oh begitu ya. Oh coba spasi, apakah dia benar? Spasi dulu di situ. Atau enter. Titik spasi coba. Oke, berarti benar ya. Tarik, kenapa tarik itu apa itu? Oke, berarti itu benar. Save dulu, save dulu.
Adolescence ya.
Ini a tutoring program mungkin ya. Yes. Tunas van den Broek is a tutoring program. Lo, kenapa dihapus yang itu?
Tutoring
program. At the Kota Kupang Church. Nanti mudah-mudahan sebelum ini ada kata, ada kepanjangan dari gimmick itu sehingga boleh di sini boleh pakai.
Yeah.
Di, oh. Tapi kalau itu baru Bikir pertama ya.
The ground kali.
If it is the first time you use it, then you have to write the complete words. The term GMIT stands for.
Belum ada kepanjangan GMIT.
Ya, kalau kita orang Kupang sebut gemit ya mungkin tahu, tapi orang Islam juga belum tentu mereka tahu kadang-kadang.
Betul.
What is gemit? They may not know.
Ya.
Nah, ibu santri ini kalau dia baru mulai jam begitu, kapan saya bergerak ini? Saya di sekolah ini.
Bukan, maksudnya begini. Hmm. Kita sampaikan di ibu santri. Hmm. Kasusnya sama dengan waktu lalu Ibu Leni dengan Pak Lawrence minggu lalu itu mereka duluan baru nanti penguji masuk. Jadi nanti ibu sendiri dengan Yantri sah.
Tapi ya terserah.
Nanti kita kasih tahu ibu santri.
Apakah nanti ya. Saya apakah ibu pakai ini Zoom-nya ibu sendiri atau bagaimana ya ini? Nanti saya kasih tahu lah. Ya, saya mau bergerak ini dari sini.
Iya, tinggal kita sampaikan.
Ya.
Kemarin
kenapa?
Juga ibu bilang.
Kemarin kenapa?
Kan juga tidak apa-apa. Nanti ibu terlambat dengan saya juga tidak apa-apa.
Iya iya. Nanti biar ibu.
Saya juga sudah antar proposal di rumahnya ibu pak. Jadi mungkin ibu sudah lihat-lihat memang sebelumnya.
Oke. Now can you
kau mengulang, kau bilang apa? Saya tidak dengar, putus-putus.
Kemarin kenapa? Saya antar proposal di rumahnya ibu pak.
Terus?
Untuk ibu lihat-lihat memang. Jadi ibu beritahu bahwa mungkin sudah pasti hari ini dia masuknya terlambat, jadi tidak apa-apa kalau duluan. Jadi nanti kalau memang sebagai pemimpin satu dan dua tidak bisa menunggu lama. Kalau dia mau, dia dengan saya sendiri saja, Pak.
Iya, menunggu lama. Kan habis memang. Kan kita 2.40 sampai 3.40. Nah, dia 3.40 baru masuk. Berarti ya menunggu lama.
Apa?
Jadi nanti kau dengan dia.
Bisa, Pak. Siap.
Dengan dia nanti semua yang all notes, suggestions, you have to note down. You have to write all notes and suggestions from Ibu Sandri. Then you need to revise all notes and suggestions and back to us as the supervisors to revise. Yeah, jadi nanti dengan Ibu Sandri.
bisa lanjut. Can you continue explaining?
Yeah.
While waiting for Ibu Santri, 10 more minutes.
Yeah. Yeah. We still have time, 20 minutes maybe. Or
next is of invitation. The researcher focused on describing the students' listening skill of the news of Sunday school English song videos to improve the skill of elementary Sunday school students through Jonas van den Broek in tutoring in Parjama, Kota Kupang.
Focused on describing.
But it can, I can use elementary here.
Jangan langsung mulai dengan kali dengan kata fokus. Nah, mungkin this writing is focused on describing. Harus ada subjek kalimat ini. This writing is focused on apa? Jadi ada subjek kalimatnya. Jangan langsung ke kata kerja seperti itu.
Focused on.
Ya, taruh subjek kalimatnya.
This research,
yeah.
Yeah.
Is.
Kenapa pakai past tense?
Ya, karena is ini.
Passive.
Yeah, passive voice.
Okay. It's focused on describing the student. Okay.
Ya, sabar ya. Kenapa of the use of Sunday school focus on describe the students listening skills of the use. Bisa through or using through.
Yeah,
pakai tadi kata through the Sunday school English song videos. Sorry. Skill of the use. By using saja. Listening skill by using. Yeah, by using bukan the, by the of the use, tapi by using.
Oh yeah.
By using the Sunday school English songs. Kedai di situ. Ganti itu. Yeah. The Sunday school English song videos. Okay. To improve
listening skill. Of Sunday school students.
Elementary-nya dihapus tuh.
Dihapus.
Pastinya berapa itu? Coba listening skill-nya ini double-double ya penulisannya. Is focus on describing the the use of the science schools. Itu coba describing. Ya, itu tadi. The use of itu sudah betul, tapi yang listening skill-nya dihapus dulu, coba. Students listening skill dihapus semua.
Tidak perlu lagi yang
hapus. Student juga. Terus.
Students listening.
Describing the use of Sunday. Itu hapus by supaya tadi benar yang the use of the Sunday school itu dihapus semua yang itu the Sunday itu hapus. the use of the Sunday school English songs videos to improve
describing the use of Sunday school listening song videos.
Tutoring program ini sebenarnya taruh programnya supaya orang tahu bahwa tutoring program bahwa itu sebuah program atau material lah ya, tapi program juga boleh. Berjemaat. Oke. Berikut coba itu scope and limitation. Sebenarnya untuk ya namanya limitation itu Anda membatasi, melimit penjel bahwa Anda bolehlah untuk menunjukkan kemampuan Anda berpikir itu Anda menambahkan apa yang tidak termasuk di sini. Misalnya orang biasa bilang kalau Anda punya scope-nya ini maka memang ini sekaligus memfokuskan atau melimit scope Anda itu di sini, tetapi yang tidak termasuk kalau Anda bisa ini yang ada kaitannya tetapi tidak termasuk. So the writer will not discuss about what. Nah, kalau bla bla bla, kalau memang
Anda
atau biasa orang mengatakan misalnya apakah Anda juga menanyakan why-nya, kalau atau karena ini hanya describing the use of the Sunday school the use of the Sunday school English song videos. Tapi orang bisa saja mempertanyakan apakah nanti Anda juga akan menjelaskan penyebab itu masalah yang dihadapi oleh siswa dalam ini kesulitan dalam listening oleh anak par itu yang bisa menjadi out of your scope gitu, sehingga Anda mengatakan this research is not going to discuss about atau the discussion of reasons or causes of the problems is beyond the scope of this research. Nah, bisa begitu. Jadi tergantung tadi pertanyaannya apa ya, your research questions.
Yeah. Can Sunday school in songs improve listening skill?
The statement of problem in this is can Sunday school students
can Sunday schools
song videos improve listening skill of elementary Sunday school? Nah, of the Sunday school ini elementary-nya dihapus, of the Sunday school students. Tek. Tidak ada lu punya keyboard kah? Sunday school students through tutoring program. Ya. Lempar jemaat. Pak itu di singkatan, jadi itu PAR itu di apa ya? Sabar, itu tanda tanya kenapa di luar dia ya? Ya, taruh program. Use of Sunday school. Ya. Sebetul itu. Tadi ya, tanda petik dua double balas tuh. balas di petik dua, bukan shift dan petik. Ada di kanan itu, di kiri enter, di sebelah kiri enter shift dulu. Aduh, lu cari di mana? Sebelah kiri dari enter. Shift dulu, tekan shift dan ada di sebelah kiri enter itu, ya? Tidak ada?
Ini kan tidak jadi Pak. Ini bukan laptop saya, jadi ini harus pakai dia punya keyboard.
Iya, tapi titik keyboard. Itu tanda tanya, jangan dipisah begitu. Coba kamu ini kontrol Z beberapa kali. Tahan kontrolnya dan tekan Z beberapa kali. Tekan saja kontrol CTRL dan Z. Kontrol mana? Kontrolnya. CTRL. Kalau begitu pakai itu back yang di atas sana, back. Kiri atas itu, back. Terus. Back. Yang melingkar itu. Panah melingkar ke kiri itu di kiri atas sana. Panah melingkar di atas sana itu.
Panah melingkar.
Di sana di ujung sana di layar itu. Itu ya. Coba ulang. Satu. Klik. Pelan-pelan. Terus. Lagi, klik lagi. Lagi. Pelan-pelan. Terus. Itu saja yang dihapus tuh. Ya, sudah. Terus panah kiri, coba tekan panah kiri. Itu deh, jangan jarak begitu. Tanda tanya mepet dong itu. Panah kiri. Ya, itu. Ya. Sana juga itu tanda ikan itu jangan dipisah begitu, jangan spasi. Tidak boleh tanda petik di spasi begitu, tidak ada itu aturan. Makanya kamu baca banyak, jangan main TikTok. Kenapa dihapus? Hapus spasinya.
Masuk, ya. Kenapa di spasi quotation mark itu?
Save dulu. Nah, nanti lu nonton ulang ini apa, lu stres nih, saya kirim ini rekaman sebentar. Lu minum air putih dulu baru lu nonton nih video. Oke. Coba kembali nanti di mana tadi? Scope kah? Ya sudahlah, nanti pikirkan pelan-pelan lah apa-apa yang tidak termasuk di dalamnya. Jadi research question tadi. Mana research question? Ini kan membantu kamu untuk memperhatikan dengan baik sebelum ini. Research question. Oh, ini sudah ya. Oh, satu pertanyaan ini saja ya. Oke. Okay. Berarti ya, can or not. Oh, iya.
Apakah pakai classroom action research?
Apakah ini? Nah, masalahnya begini. Ada lagi, ada kesalahan umum mahasiswa. Waktu mereka penelitian, mereka berpikir mereka harus mengajar. Ini salah. Mengajar, antara mengajar dan penelitian itu dua hal yang berbeda. Karena kamu punya kemampuan mengajar itu belum bisa standar. Jadi tidak bisa mengukur, tidak bisa mengatakan bahwa ini apa tidak bisa atau ini di par ini bisa. Jadi itu beda, dua hal yang berbeda. Kecuali kamu memang sudah ada sertifikat sebagai guru par di sana, yang kebetulan kamu guru par dan ada sertifikat diakui sebagai seorang guru par di sana, itu juga harus dijelaskan bahwa karena ini kan nanti membuat generalisasi, membuat apa ya? Ya generalisasi di hasil itu bahwa dari hasil penelitian diperoleh ternyata using English song videos, Sunday school English song videos itu bisa mengimprove listening skill dari students. Benar-benar karena metodenya yang berpengaruh, bukan karena kamu punya kemampuan yang ini. Jadi itu salah satu hal yang harus diperhatikan untuk benar-benar mendapatkan hasil yang bisa dipercaya, maka harus eliminate faktor-faktor penyebab lain yang menimbulkan buruknya hasil. Jadi kalau misalnya hasilnya buruk, benar-benar karena metodenya itu yang apa, yang Sunday School English songs itu yang memang buruk, bukan karena kamu yang mengajar yang buruk. Artinya harus pastikan bahwa kamu ngajar tidak buruk, sehingga benar-benar hasil itu karena memang program Sunday School apa Vandenbroek English Tutoring Program itu yang benar-benar diukur gitu. Makanya biasanya instrumen itu selalu diuji, reliability apa yang satu lagi,
reliability validity
dan reliability, itu dua hal itu untuk sebuah instrumen gitu. Nah, sama juga yang ini. Kalau kamu mengajar, itu pasti beda. Walaupun bagus programnya, tapi karena kamu ngajarnya belum bisa, kamu belum punya standar kemampuan mengajar yang bagus, maka hasilnya buruk. Akhirnya orang mengatakan, wah, ternyata buruk ya ini program ini Vandenbroek. Padahal yang menyebabkan buruk hasil karena kamu yang ngajarnya tidak ini. Jadi dalam hal ini, ayo also teaching the using the method or instrument or something or the program. Are you going to teach yourself or there is someone else doing the teaching and then you record, you interview the teacher. What is going to happen?
I'm to ask another teacher to teach with this method, and I'm going to interview.
So your answer and is it
another teacher?
You just change the plan because I asked you this thing, or you already planned beginning?
Already planned the beginning.
Okay.
Like what you say before.
Okay, so who is the one that is going to teach? Who is the teacher?
One of the teachers. One of the teachers.
Okay. But you are also one of the teachers at the par.
Yes, sir.
Are you also teaching one of the staff of Vandenbroek, or what is that called, Cahaya Bagi Negeri organization? Are you also one of the staff there? Which one are you included? Yeah,
we are as relawan. Yeah.
Okay. Volunteer.
Volunteers.
Yes.
Volunteers of teaching.
Okay. Yes, so Cahaya Bagi Negeri, you also work for that CBN. Okay. Then you need to explain in chapter 3, saying
it's even instrument.
Yeah.
Instrument.
Yeah, or data sources. You explain that even though the writer is also one of the staff or teachers at the Cahaya Bagi Bangsa organization, who is also teaching every Sunday, but in order to guarantee the result of the research, then the researcher decides not to do the teaching. Instead, she will ask someone else to do the teaching, and she will only record the teaching process and collect the result. Also, she will do interview when needed or when necessary. Gitu. Jadi itu harus dijelaskan. Kamu juga harus kasih tahu di tulisan itu bahwa kamu juga pengajar di sana. Tetapi untuk menjamin validitas ataupun mencegah bias data, karena kamu yang ini, siapa tahu orang bilang, ah kamu kan peneliti, kamu ngajar, kamu pastilah kamu bikin-bikin dia punya hasil supaya bagus. Ya, itu kecurigaan orang. Itu ilmiah juga kalau orang curiga itu. Tapi Anda yakinkan dalam 1-2 kalimat bahwa untuk menghindari bias dan subjektivitas, ya, itu dua kalimat itu, bias dan subjektivitas, maka penulis atau peneliti memutuskan untuk tidak melakukan proses belajar mengajar sendiri. Instead, she will ask another teacher to do the teaching. Oke, begitu. Nanti dijelaskan dengan baik. Oke, memang metode ini yang sangat penting ya, Prof. Bahwa nanti teori-teori itu tinggal mengikuti, tapi metode cara mengumpulkan data, cara meneliti, cara mengolah datanya, itu yang nanti dia harus paham. Dia olah mana data. Kamu olah datanya bagaimana? Jadi atau proses pengambilan datanya dulu lah. Kamu ambil mengambil datanya bagaimana cara? How will you collect the data?
Like the to collect the data.
How to collect and, data?
I will give the students the test. There are pre-test and post-test. And another technique is I give them questionnaire as the additional data.
Okay. Good. So you are only collecting the data. You are not going to do the teaching. Okay. Then if you need to interview the teacher of that class, specific class, then you do the interview. Okay. But all the instruments like questionnaires, you have to discuss with us. Itu questionnaire itu harus consult. Kita lihat dulu.
Itu
juga materinya.
Itu di, Kau pakai questionnaire juga?
Yes, sir. Questionnaire.
Questionnaire. Bisa karena untuk melihat apakah berpengaruh, dia bisa tanya, okay, perkembangan kamu menggunakan ini bagaimana? Terus apakah bagus? Kamu bisa mendengar dengan baik? Kamu bisa pahami setelah mengikuti ini? Oh ya bagus. Kamu senang tidak? Ya bagus. Jadi itu semua jawaban mereka bisa ditulis. Jadi ini dia deskriptif atau dia dia?
Kenapa?
Lanjut, Prof.
Tidak, maksudnya di sini kan dia hanya pakai interview. Techniques of data collection-nya kan interview, observation, test, documentation. Mana questionnaire?
Pakai questionnaire kah?
Mau pakai questionnaire?
Di bagian research procedure. Research procedure ada planning, ada action. Nah,
tidak.
Action itu
kalau questionnaire itu salah satu teknik. Salah satu teknik of data collection itu teknik, bukan kamu masukkan di mana lagi.
Instrument of data collection.
Instrument.
Yes, sir.
Instrument.
Dia harus masuk di sini. Dia masuk technique of data collection. Instrument or technique kalau.
Dia masuk ke instrument, Prof.
Iya.
Karena dia bukan. Kuesioner itu kita tidak ngomong tentang aksennya di lapangan bahwa dia ini, tapi bahwa itu kuesioner sebagai alat, ya, sebagai bahan atau alat. Nah, jadi dia masuk ke instrumen. Nanti wawancara itu ya teknik bahwa dia mewawancarai menggunakan, dia bisa membacakan itu kuesioner tadi, dia bisa menggunakan itu kuesioner yang sama untuk dibacakan untuk ditanya dan dia record, bisa juga record atau ada
itu
checklist.
Interview.
Ya, interview. Atau bisa dengan ya. Cara checklist juga, langsung checklist. Oke, okay, yes, no. Ya. Yes or no, Ibu ya. Santi masuk. Ya. Jadi bisa ada interview, ada observation, ada test. Test itu ya. how many test? Ya. Itu kalau ada pre-test kah, ada post-test? Kalau ya kalau begitu harus jamak ya, kalau pre-test, post-test.
Ini Ibu Santri kayaknya sudah masuk, Prof.
Oh iya. Ya, welcome Ibu Santri.
Ya, yeah, thank you Bapak. Sorry I'm late.
It's okay, Ibu. Ya. Yeah.
Good afternoon, Yanti.
Yeah, we are just having discussion with Santri, looking at her summary of proposal and also trying to find out what she is going, what it means by specific terms, like because she has the program, what is called the Vandenbroek tutoring, English tutoring. Is it a program or is it the name of organization? See, then we found out that it's actually a program that is being used when teaching those English Sunday school students at Kota Kupang Church. Begitu.
Yeah.
So okay. we have been supervising her. Since the very beginning of our proposal writing process, but of course this is the also good opportunity also for us to talk directly to her because of the COVID-19 darurat era. That's why we spent some time before while waiting for you, Ibu, discussing having I talk with him, with her. Now, as you are already here, Ibu, so you can take your turn or take over the whole process of the discussion. I am now at school. I am planning to move to my house, but I will let this computer on while driving. So the Zoom meeting will be will keep running. What do you think? Or would you like to use your Zoom, Ibu, so we can?
Yeah.
But it's,
because I'm moving.
That's okay, but
I'll be driving.
Just. Mm-hmm. If you don't mind, you just let your computer on.
Oh, okay.
Just let it be on. Yeah.
Yes, okay.
It's going to be easy for you. Yeah, thank you.
Okay, yeah. Baik, Ibu. So you can take over the running of the discussion, Ibu. Yantri is ready. She has been ready. She has been with us. So I think she is happy to have all your suggestions, corrections, and also advices. Ibu, yeah.
Yes, sir. Thank you
so much. Yeah, time and place is yours, Ibu. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Pak. Yantri. I noticed that your title is it's a kind of a little bit complicated for me, and I guess it will be for your readers to understand. The use of Sunday school English song videos to improve listening skill for elementary Sunday school students through Tunas funded group English tutoring in Parjemaat Kota Kupang. Well, it seems to me that you are trying to put all the things that you are going to do in your title, but it doesn't have to be like that.
Yeah, you're right.
Your title, your title can be short. And simple or short, and it doesn't have to be this specific.
Yeah, brief. Okay, it should be brief enough. Yeah.
Yeah. If you said, like Pak Man explained just now, if what you are trying to do is to look at how students' listening skill is going to be improved through this Tunas van den Broek English tutoring, then you can reformulate the title. Would you please say again, what is Tunas van den Broek English tutoring? What is it, sorry?
Yes, Miss Tunas van den Broek is one of tutoring in Parjemat Kota Kupang that's collaborated with Cahaya Bagi Negeri Foundation, and it's prepared the elementary students from class 1 until 6. And the students are in the Tunas van den Broek are Sunday school students, taken from Sunday school students.
So is it an English course or what?
No, ma'am. Like a tutoring.
Only English. Use English all the time.
No, ma'am.
So would you please explain in detail what this van den Broek English tutoring is, and so it's going to be easier for us to to rephrase or reformulate your title.
Thank you. Tunas van den Broek is the name of Jemaat Kota Kupang. It is the name of his story. It is the Cahaya Bangsa Negeri.
Cahaya
Bagi Nation. May choose Parjemat Kota Kupang. Parjemat Kota Kupang to prepare all of the Sunday school students to follow all of the subject in their school just for elementary students.
So
the name of Tunas van den Broek itself it is from the history of Gemit Kota Kupang Gemit Charts.
So is it a kind of program from the church?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So this tutoring is a program from Kota Kupang Church. Is that what you're trying to say? Oh,
yes.
Okay. So you might consider using the aim is to teach listening. Is that correct? Yantri, aim is to teach listening?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So the aim is to teach listening, right?
Yes.
Listening is not the only one, but maybe it just happened that you are going to do research on listening in particular. But this program runs tutoring for many skills or many subjects. Is it correct?
Oh yes, I got it. I see. In the tutoring, the aim of the tutoring is to tell every subject.
To teach
every subject.
All subjects.
To teach. Teaches and. Yes, sir, to teach.
Mm-hmm. All subjects.
But here in your study, you're focusing on listening skill. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes,
okay.
And listening skill.
So what about if your title goes like this? Improving Sunday Sunday School Students Listening Skill through Tunas Van Den Broek English Tutoring Program. And then when you come inside, you can explain every detail that you want to explain, but don't put every single thing here.
Yeah.
I think it is so simple and it's easy to me.
Mm-hmm.
It seems simple in the title, but as Ivosandri said, that you need to explain more inside of your proposal.
Yeah, that's true, Payan. So because if you have put everything here in the title, then there will be no surprise, no surprising element.
Your thesis. Yeah.
So if you put just a big picture of it in the title, then your readers will be curious to know what is inside. What's the program actually?
Yeah,
and they will have a kind of willingness to read your thesis. That's what I mean.
Yeah.
Do you understand, Yanti, what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay. So that's my idea. But you can go and talk to your supervisors again.
I do agree with the title given by Ivosandri.
Mm-hmm. I also agree. I also agree.
Yeah.
And Yantri, your research problem, the research problem is, can Sunday school English song videos improve listening skill of elementary Sunday school students through Tunas Van Den Broek English Tutoring in Parjana Kota Kupang? Is that the only thing you want to find out? Because it's a yes, no question, well, which is okay. But if that's the only thing that you want to find out, it's a little bit, it's too simple, I guess, for S1 students. Mm. Because if you just want to find out can or cannot, then that's it.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm sorry, ma'am. I can hear you.
Clearly. Oh, you can't hear me?
Yes, I can hear you clearly.
My God, it's very clear.
It's very clear again. What's wrong with your speaker?
Our audio.
The connection, the connection.
Yeah, your connection, I guess. Yeah, okay. Yeah, Yantri.
Because
your question is. Your question is yes, no question, right?
Yeah.
Can Sunday school? Okay. If the answer is yes, then what next, Yantri? Can you answer me? If the answer is yes, then what? What are you going to do if the answer is yes?
I just do one research problem because
well, that's okay with one research problems, but my question now is after that what if you find out that yes it can improve the student's listening skill, then what? You're going to answer yes and that's it?
Yantri.
Yantri, if you remember your scope and limitation of your research, you mentioned that you are going to describe how the listening skill of the students is. So maybe the second question is how. Whether or not could be the first question, and then how it is it could be the second one. Then to answer, you give description, describing. Can you go? Sorry, Ibu. Can you go to page with limitation, scope and limitation, Yantri? Yeah. Okay, so this research is focused on describing the use of the Sunday School English song videos to improve listening skill. So you are going to describe actually. What about the question from Ibu Santri saying, based on your research question, saying can the listening skill be improved using this method? Then what about the describing thing? Are they only one thing or they are different? They are separate things. If they are separate, then you can make them two different questions and two different aims.
Different aims?
Do you understand? Do you understand? Yang pertama kan can Sunday School English song videos improve? Itu kalau itu pertanyaan pertama, then you have to test, you have to do interview and so on, and then if you would like to add one more question, then you describe as what you already mentioned in your scope and limitation. Yeah. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
If I say yes, I have to implement it in the teaching of listening.
No. You are not going to implement it. You are going to explain how the listening skill is. You go back to scope and limitation. Sorry, Ibu.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is to help her to understand Ibu's question. Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Scope
and limitation.
Yeah. You are saying here, this research is focused on describing the use of the Sunday School English song videos. Which one are you going to do? Describing or answering the can it? Or two things, or both of them? Are you going to do both? Or you are going to do the describing? This, yeah, describing of the use of the Sunday School English song videos? Or only answering the question can, and so on. Itu yang dimaksud Ibu tadi. Kurang dengar?
Yes, sir. I want to describing. Describing.
Describe.
Ya, okay, Ibu. Silakan, Ibu.
Okay, thank you, Pak. Thank you.
Yeah.
If you say you want to describe, then you need to put additional question. So, okay, you can put the first question as what you've stated here. Can Sunday School English songs blah 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 Jemaat Kota Kupang. That's the first one. Okay? And then you might come to, because I noticed that in your second chapter, if you go to your review of related literature, your second chapter, you have provided types of listening and process of listening, which is good as the starting point. So you might want to consider finding out about types of listening taught to these students. What types of listening that is effective to improve the students' listening skill? Because there are several types here. So you might want to consider which types of listening is useful or is effective for improving students' listening skill, either intensive or selective. Or you have the other one, interactive, responsive, autonomous. Do you understand?
Yes.
Okay. And then you also have process of listening. It's also, it's going to be interesting, I guess, if you want to take this one as well in your research questions. So the first question is that one, and then the second one you might consider from types of listening and the process of listening. You describe the process of using songs, video songs, to teach listening to these kids. Well, again, that's my personal ideas. If you want to, let's say you want to change or you want to add, of course you have to talk and discuss with your supervisor. But for me, if you have only one question, then it's too narrow.
Mm-hmm.
You can't elaborate much. Mm. So you might want to consider adding about types and process in order to be able to describe every single thing in the teaching and learning process using the video. Classroom action research. Mm-hmm. Are you sure? Are you sure that this is really classroom action research? Yantri?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, again, I'm not saying that it's wrong. I just want to find out more from you.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, what do you understand about classroom action research? And why are you trying to use classroom action research in your study? And not only classroom research.
For me, classroom action research is a method of finding out what works best in teacher's classroom.
Mm-hmm.
So that he or she can improve students' learning, that it's a goal to improve teachers on classroom. And why I choose... action research, it is the problem is exactly faced by problems that come up steadily in the classroom when teachers teaching or the teaching and learning process in the classroom.
Okay, it means that you know what classroom action research is. Now, my next question is, are you one of the tutors in this program?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you are one of the tutors. Mm. And have you found problems or any gaps so far in teaching students listening skill?
Yes, ma'am.
Because the basic thing of using classroom action research is whenever there is a problem or whenever there is a gap in the classroom that you want to what is the basic condition of these students that makes you think of improving their skills?
Almost of the students there are lack of English, especially in listening skill, and in Vandenbroek is the facilitating is not enough. And another I seen the application of video as a method or media teaching English, so I decide to do my research at this tutoring program.
Okay, by using classroom action research.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Are you going to use lesson plan?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, then make sure that we don't know still how many cycles are you going to go through, because you haven't had any idea, right, about the students' improvement. But every cycle has to be followed by the improvement or lesson plan. So you have to make a change in the lesson plan.
Yeah.
Well, I'm still not sure. I don't know. I can't talk much on this because I'm still, or I should say, so far I haven't met any studies using classroom action research outside teaching and learning in school. This is the first time, if I'm not mistaken. So, well, if you do in your research, if you do what is supposed to be done in the process of classroom action research, then they might be great. Well, let's see what you're going to come up with. And then what are you going to do in your research? Sorry, I missed your presentation. So what are you going to do in your research?
What are you going to do, Yandre?
In my research, I'm going to do the tests. There are pre-tests and post-tests, and also I will give the students questionnaire as the another technique, and it becomes additional data.
So first, you're going to give them tests. One group, pre-test, yeah, post-test. Yeah. So what you're going to do is you're going to statistically compare the results of pre-test and post-test. Correct?
Yes. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Correlation coefficient. Are you going to use that in your statistical analysis?
The analysis. Ma'am?
Yeah. How are you going to analyze the data? Statistically?
Yes, ma'am. I want to use two techniques, the qualitative and quantitative method. The formula to describe and to know the mean of the students, and use x equals sigma x per n.
Okay,
and
okay.
Where the x.
Yeah, Yanti, I can see the formula here in your chapter 3.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's for the test. And what about the materials? What kind of materials are you going to use to test them? What about the questions? What kind of question are you going to give them? Questions related to their lessons in Sunday school, or related to their school lessons?
Related to their school lessons.
Yeah, school lessons. School lessons.
So nothing to do with the materials of Sunday school.
Yes.
Then what's yes, okay? Nothing to do with the materials in Sunday school, like stories about Jesus, and so on and so forth. Nothing to do with that. Yantri, can you hear me?
Sorry.
No?
I can hear clearly.
Yantri. So.
Sorry, ma'am. I can hear you clearly. I can hear you clearly.
Ayan, can you repeat the question for her?
Would you please repeat the question, ma'am?
Oh, Yantri.
Okay. Okay, Yantri. My question is about the material that you're going to use to test your students, or the questions in the pre-test and post-test. Are you going to use the lessons in their Sunday school, or are you going to use the lessons from the schools?
Yeah.
Their daily schools, not Sunday schools.
No, I mean, use the lesson from the Sunday school.
The Sunday school. So can you give one example, one or two examples of the questions?
Yeah. Wait, kasih tas dong.
You should have your instrument with you.
Yeah.
This is a seminar of your proposal. You should have the questions, all the instruments. Okay.
One of the example, ma'am, is the song. The title of the song of My God is So Big.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Oh, My God is So Big. It is the lyrics of. The lyrics of the of a song of okay. a song, and I prepared the video for students, and there are two words that similar, and they the students have to listen carefully and choose which one is the correct. And next is I use the I got the joy. This the correct incorrect sentence, and the students have to arrange word by word with correct sentence that they hear from the video, like this one.
That's for the pretest.
Yeah.
So yes, you're going to use two songs in the pretest.
And the last is fill the blank.
How many songs are you going to use in the pretest?
My God is So Big.
How many songs?
How many songs are you going to use?
Three songs.
Oh, okay. You're going to use three songs. With three types of questions in the pretest, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes,
ma'am. And what about the post-test? How many songs are you going to use? Are you going to use different songs in the post-test?
No, ma'am. I'm going to use.
I am going.
The same song, but I'm going to use the same song, but this. There has a different questions here.
Different questions. Okay. Now, after the first test, are you going to discuss the correct answer with the students?
Yes, ma'am.
After the pretest. So after the pretest, you are discussing the correct answer with the students, but you're not going to give similar questions in the post-test. Am I right?
Yes, you are right.
Okay, now let's assume it's a hypothetical question. Let's assume if their post-test, the scores of the post-test is higher than the pre-test, okay? How can you be so sure that's the only factor that influence is the materials that you use to teach? Do you understand my questions, Yantri?
How will you control?
It seems that you have difficulties in listening to my voice.
No, connection, internet connection.
Yeah, I guess so, internet connection in her place.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe she doesn't understand the question.
Ma'am, I'm sorry.
Sorry?
Why do you stay so far away from the internet jaringan spot?
How are you going to control, Yantri? How are you going to control the result of the test? Or in other words, how can you be sure that the improvement of the scores is because of the materials that you are using to teach?
Or the method. Yeah.
Okay.
The tutoring.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, ma'am.
Program, yeah.
Because the method is really for me it's many students interest to sing a song and song also has important role to improve the listening and this media also make the day more active and enjoy the lesson well because many students in Tunas Van Den Broek so difficulties in
Yantri, you're not answering my question. My question is, how are you going to control the result of the test? Mm-hmm. I'm talking about the result of the test.
Result of the test.
I'm going to control how I'm going to control the result of my test.
How do you control whether the improvement of the students' listening skills is caused by the material from the Van Den Broek something, not by any other things? Yantri.
I just want to find it.
Kamu dengar tadi penjelasan saya tadi. Halo. Tadi sebelumnya itu kan kita bicara bagaimana kamu mengontrol hasilnya. Mengontrol hasil bahwa itu benar-benar disebabkan oleh materi yang kamu gunakan sehingga anak-anak punya listening skills itu menjadi lebih baik pada saat post-test, bukan karena hal lain, bukan karena penjelasan kamu, bukan karena apa lagi ya, bukan karena memang ada faktor lain, misalnya anak-anak itu punya hobi mendengarkan lagu di rumah misalnya. How will you control that the improvement is only caused by the use of the material from the Van Den Broek tutoring organization or something?
Yeah, that's true, Pa. So let me use Bahasa Indonesia, Yantri, if you're still confused. It seems like looking at your face, I'm sure that you are getting confused.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But this is very important.
Question. Yeah, it's a very important question, Ibu. Yeah.
Very important. That's why I have to use Bahasa Indonesia in explaining it to you. Jadi begini, Yantri. Kan nanti Anda bikin pretest, ya kan? Ya, Yantri. Ya. Pretest kemudian posttest. Kemudian Anda compare nilai pretest dan posttest.
Posttest, ya.
Okay. Nah, katakanlah hasilnya itu semua mengalami kenaikan nilai. Jadi nilai rata-rata dari 50 sekian katakanlah naik sampai 90. Nah, bagaimana Anda mengontrol atau bagaimana Anda yakin bahwa kenaikan dari 50 ke 90 itu karena benar-benar dari hasil ini, hasil program tutoring ini, dari hasil mengajar dengan Sunday School English Songs video ini, bukan karena faktor lain. Jadi bukan karena di rumah mungkin mereka sering mendengar lagu yang sama atau mereka mengikuti kursus di luar misalnya dasarnya memang mereka sangat terbiasa dengan kosakata. Kan ini sangat spesifik nih, Anda punya proses pembelajaran ini, materinya sangat spesifik karena tadi Anda bilang berurusan dengan sekolah minggu saja, ya kan, bukan urusan sekolah. Artinya kosakata yang ada kan paling yang itu-itu juga. Yeah, Jesus is good to me. Jesus bless me all the time. Paling apalagi untuk anak sekolah minggu kan. Nah, itu Anda harus bisa cover semua penjelasan. Karena ini sangat spesifik materinya. Nah, sekarang pertanyaan saya kembali, bagaimana Anda meyakinkan, well at least kami bertiga. Bagaimana Anda meyakinkan kami bertiga bahwa look, Bapak Ibu, ini hasil memang karena saya punya mengajar. yang pakai ini songs di video. Itu yang bikin mereka punya nilai naik, bukan karena faktor lain. Bagaimana caranya? Saya sudah pakai bahasa Indonesia loh ya.
Santri. Yantri, misalnya kamu kontrol di pemilihan apa sampel misalnya. Kamu harus wawancara dulu sebelum itu misalnya memilih sampel.
Yeah.
Misalnya ada orang yang memang hobinya nyanyi dan menghafal lagu dan lain-lain, itu kamu harus harus coret dari daftar itu sehingga mereka betul-betul homogen. Homogen itu apa situasi awal mereka, kondisi awal mereka itu harus betul-betul seragam. Kalau ada orang yang lebih pintar, yang sangat pintar atau sangat bagus bahasa Inggrisnya, kamu harus coret, harus keluarkan dia dari daftar data resource sumber informan atau apa subjek. Itu maksud dari Ibu Santri Yantri. Kamu ngerti tidak? Jadi harus eliminate itu faktor-faktor yang mempengaruhi hasil, bukan karena yang nantinya akhirnya bias, bukan karena metode itu, bukan karena materi itu, tapi justru faktor lain. Ya, salah satu itu tadi, kamu harus cek dulu prior knowledge dari anak-anak itu, pre-condition dari anak-anak itu. Gitu, kamu catat ya, itu penting sekali. It's very important.
Ya, baik. Ya. Terima kasih.
Apalagi cara mengontrol hasil itu sehingga benar-benar karena materi itu, hal lain lagi apa? What are the things are you going to do or can you do? One is eliminating students with very very good skills of English. The other things that you can do. Itu yang dimaksud Ibu Santri tadi. How will you control? Untuk menghindari subjektivitas dalam pengambilan data, dalam membuat penilaian, baguslah bahwa kamu tidak, you are not going to do the teaching yourself. Okay, you ask somebody else, even though you are one of the teachers or tutors in that organization, you limit your involvement only in collecting data, doing interview and so on, not doing the teaching yourself to the same class. Kira-kira begitu bisa Ibu, kita saran kasih dia seperti itu.
I do agree with that. Yang apalagi yang berhubungan dengan pemilihan sampel, itu sangat penting. Harus homogenitasnya harus diperhatikan ya, Yantri. Tidak bisa ada yang bagus. Kamu tidak bisa pakai semua yang ada di dalam kelas karena mungkin di situ ada yang setiap dia dari international school misalnya. Setiap hari dia pakai bilingual di kelas. Jadi bahasa Inggris itu sudah jadi makanan dia sehari-hari. Terus mungkin ada yang ikut kursus. Nah, tidak bisa kita taruh bersamaan dengan yang lain. Jadi betul-betul harus ambil, kalau misalnya dia harus purposive. Karena memang tujuannya untuk meningkatkan mereka punya ini. Jadi mulai ambil kalau mau dari nol semua, harus ambil yang dari nol semua. Yang memang sama-sama tidak tahu. Tidak bisa ada satu kelas yang, karena kamu bilang cuma satu kelas, ambil semua, tidak bisa. Ini tidak sama, ceritanya tidak akan sama dengan kelas di sekolah. Nah, itu kita belum bicara mengenai scope. Jadi, apakah yang Anda maksud dengan improve listening skill ini, listening skill general English, untuk general English, atau listening, karena ini kan orang akan tanya, loh, karena itu materi itu kan sangat-sangat spesifik. Scope-nya sangat kecil. Ya. Terus bagaimana mungkin mereka punya listening skill secara keseluruhan di dalam bahasa Inggris bisa diimprove? Coba bagaimana penjelasannya kalau begitu? Seperti tadi kan, paling lagu coba kamu lihat lagi lagu yang kamu ambil tiga itu, ada berapa banyak yang akan mereka pelajari dari kosakata di dalam? Kan tidak banyak. kalau kita tahu lagu bagus kalau itu kan bahasanya hanya begitu-begitu saja gitu kan. Dia tidak sama dengan listening in general. Itu juga akan pasti akan diangkat jadi satu pertanyaan. Kenapa hanya mendengar dari skop kecil ini saja bisa kita bisa berasumsi bahwa anak-anak punya listening skill secara keseluruhan bisa meningkat. Nah, sekarang kalau misalnya saya tanya begitu, Yantri jawabnya bagaimana? Karena di sini hanya bilang improve listening skill. Artinya kita punya asumsi listening skill in general.
Iya, betul.
Jadi kalau dia ke sekolah, katakanlah dia punya nilai bagus di 3 lagu itu, kemudian diajar dengan beberapa lagu yang ada hubungannya dengan lagu-lagu sekolah minggu, Yantri berasumsi bahwa nanti di ke sekolah, pelajaran listening di sekolah, dia akan selesaikan secara gampang. Apakah seperti itu? Atau listening skill di sini yang dimaksud listening skill yang ada hubungannya hanya dengan program of Sunday school? Do you want to say something?
Yantri.
Baik, terima kasih. Ya, baik, terima kasih Ibu. Jadi yang saya maksud di sini adalah listening skill khususnya untuk Sunday school saja. Sunday school saja untuk mengontrol, dan memastikan bahwa hasil yang saya akan dapatkan itu pure. Saya ya seperti yang tadi Ibu bilang bahwa saya harus mengontrol, saya harus memilih anak-anak dari yang betul-betul dari nol. Dan itu juga terjawab dalam instrumen saya waktu interview juga dan observasi. Karena yang jelas bahwa saya akan menginterview yang mengajar adalah bukan saya tapi another teacher. Jadi saya di situ betul-betul sebagai researcher. Jadi saya itu juga sangat data itu juga akan sangat membantu saya meyakinkan kepada ibu-ibu dan bapak dan pak bahwa itu benar-benar dari yang saya terapkan.
Yantri, kita sudah paham itu, baguslah bahwa kamu juga paham. Tapi pertanyaan terakhir ibu tadi tentang scope itu, kalau kamu hanya menyebut English listening skills itu tanpa membatasi scope-nya, itu sangat luas itu, listening itu terlalu luas. Tapi kamu harus memastikan sesuai saran ibu tadi dan itu benar bahwa nanti yang kamu ukur itu hanya ya kemampuan yang dibutuhkan sehari-hari di Sunday school itu saja.
Sunday school.
Ya. Itu supaya misalnya apa kebiasaan mereka harus memahami penjelasan guru sekolah minggu dalam bahasa Inggris yang disampaikan secara lisan. They can take actions after an order or request from the teachers because they understand what the teacher is saying. Begitu, jadi jangan listening in general itu. Jadi harus dipersempit scope yang diukur nanti. Itu maksud ibu. Itu betul, itu bagus. Sangat penting. Kalau kamu mengukur yang begitu luas listening secara ini luas itu mau mendengarkan apa? Mendengarkan itu banyak yang harus didengar. Tapi kalau hanya untuk kebutuhan di Sunday school saja lebih gampang. Dan itu juga termasuk dalam membatasi scope dan juga mengontrol hasil. Hasil dari penggunaan itu materi tadi itu. Mungkin kira-kira begitu, kok Ibu?
Iya, Pak. Ya. Jadi harus ditambah di scope and limitation Yantri bahwa yang dimaksud dengan listening skill di sini dibatasi pada listening skill untuk Sunday school. Karena listening skill, kalau listening skill saja terlalu luas, sedangkan materi yang dikasih materi yang hanya berurusan dengan, jadi misalnya misalnya kita berurusan dengan teknik misalnya, kita hanya mendengar latihan-latihan listening mengenai teknik, tetapi kita tidak bisa bilang bahwa itu untuk meningkatkan kemampuan mereka listening skill secara umum, karena listening skill di area mereka saja, di bidang mereka saja gitu loh. Nah sama persis dengan ini yang sekolah minggu, jadi harus ditambah di scope and limitation. I think that's all from me, Pak Man and Pak Ian.
Ibu. Terima kasih banyak. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Ibu. You have raised very important issues on Yantri's. Sorry, Yantri's. Nama mirip-mirip ini. Sorry. On Yantri's research plan. Because this is a research plan, then she is lucky that we are, especially you, helping her so much, Ibu. Thank you for raising all the very important things. It will help her so much. I also record this seminar, proposal seminar, and I ask for your permission, if you don't mind, I will post it on my YouTube channel to make it light enough for Yantri to watch again. Instead of sending the file to her through WhatsApp application, it's difficult. Better, because it will also be useful for other people. So they can work other students, Ibu. So thank you.
Yes, Pak.
Foto dulu, Pro, foto dulu supaya sebentar ini apa?
Oh begitu ya. Kalau begitu ini Yantri bisa close atau saya foto satu kali dan
foto,
saya
foto.